Central and Shangwan are districts in Hong Kong where old and new come together. A small community with traces of history and a world-famous financial center. It's been described as a miracle. How was this miracle created? Looking back, how did we preserve the memories of this community in the last 100 years? The area from Wan Chai to Central and Sheung Wan was known as Victoria City in Hong Kong's early days. They were the first areas to be developed, where East and West existed side by side. This and the impact of Western education made this little place a cradle for new ideas. The 1911 revolution, which changed Chinese history of the last 100 years, was incubated in Hong Kong.
In this area, it's the place of Chinese culture. 原因就是因為環聚居他們當然是有我們中國文化的根在，然後在1842年之後，大家知道基督教相繼來到中國宣教，他們的傳教對象就是華人，所以他就在上環和中環交界的一些地區建立他們的宣教的場所，辦學校，直到華人在接受西方的教育認識西方的文化，
知道他們眼界大開，產生了新思想，在這樣的背景之下，他們就有改革思想，然後最後他們認為清政府是無可救藥，他們就提出用武力去推翻他們，所以革命運動就在香港上環這個地區就出現了。The University of Hong Kong is the city's first university. Lok Yew Hall was built in 1912, a year after the 1911 revolution successfully overthrew the Manchurian Qing government. Dr. Sun Yat-sen came to Hong Kong again in 1923. And on the 20th of February at 11 a.m., he gave a talk in Lok Yew Hall. He said, "When people asked where and how I got my revolutionary thinking, I told them the truth. I got my revolutionary ideas from Hong Kong."
Sun Yat-sen, in my behind, Lok Yew Hall, once published a very important speech. This speech explains why he had the revolutionary thinking. In this speech, he mentioned that the revolutionary thinking was originated in Hong Kong. Why did it appear? The reason is that when he was in Hong Kong studying and living, he saw Hong Kong political and society progress. Then, in his very close hometown, every time he went to look at his hometown situation, he found that compared to Hong Kong, it was behind. So, in this situation, he thought that why the two countries have such a big difference? He thought that it should be implemented as a change. 當呢個改良係以咩咧？以香港、以英國作為佢模仿嘅對象，呢個就係佢革命思想嘅產生。In
1887, Dr. Sun Yat-sen was studying at the College of Medicine for Chinese, where he met Yang He-lin, Yao Lit, and Chen Xiaobai. Standing at the back is Guan Jingliang. The students held meetings at Yang Yaoji on Gough Street, expounding on politics and affairs of the country. Among them, Yang He-ling, Yao Lit, Chen Xiaobai, and Sun Yat-sen were nicknamed the Four Desperados.
Hong Kong is the so called new generation of intellectuals who first appeared. The reason is because Hong Kong is the first place in Hong Kong to appear in classical education. Since the 1849 中央書院，1862年，然後就係呢個聖若瑟書院，1875年啦，即係 其實呢啲咁嘅學校嘅出現咧，就培養咗一批咧，我哋叫雙語精英，即係佢哋一方面有中文嘅根基，二方面咧亦都係識英文嘅，變咗佢哋咧就係最早能夠接觸到西方嘅一啲思想。內地同時期嘅人咧，仍然仲係考科舉嘅，咁變咗咧就係相差好遠。咁呢批人因為佢哋比較早接觸到西方思想咧，咁佢哋容易接受一啲即係君主立憲啊，或者甚至係即係革命啊呢啲思想。
Today's central Anshan Wan is still a commercial and political hub. It was a cradle for new ideas over 100 years ago. In Paxi Lane, a group of intellectuals who had received Western education founded a political commentary group named Phu Ren Literary Society. The most representative of these patriotic young people were Yun Ku Wan, who received Western education in Hong Kong, and Tse Tan Tai, who had studied overseas. It was Hong Kong's earliest political commentary group. They were also the core members of Xin Chong Hui, which instigated the first revolution in
1895。喺我背後係富人文社嘅所在地，呢個地方我哋好有歷史感。呢個係我哋香港第一代嘅年青人，愛國年青人嘅產生，佢哋對祖國嘅關懷。我哋香港雖然係殖民地，但係我哋同近代中國嘅歷史係息息相關。呢批人可五派係第一批人，係值得我哋紀念嘅。
亦都反映到咧，係當時嘅香港其實一來。就已經有咁嘅氣候，二來亦都有咁樣嘅條件，係可以咧係產生好似興中會一個咁樣嘅革命組織。咁呢個就係即係其實富人民社係一個先行者嘅一個咁樣嘅形式啦。咁所以就係、如果孫中山先生當年佢搞嘅興中會，香港搞興中會嘅時候咧，唔係已經有好似富人民社一個咁嘅組織，而大家可以將佢合拼而成一個新組織嘅話咧？其實當時佢哋能唔能夠喺咁短嘅時間招募到咁多嘅會員咧，其實係有疑問。
Gough Street, where Dr. Sun Yat-sen used to comment on politics, was only a block away from Park Si Lane, where Phu Ren Literary Society used to be. On a chance occasion, Sun Yat-sen made the acquaintance of Yun Ku Wan through Yao Lit.They hit it off right away, laying the foundation for revolution. Pervasive discontent in society at the time led like-minded intellectuals such as Sun Yat-sen, Yun Ku Wan, and Tse Tan Tai to set up Xin Chong Hui in Tian Heung Hang on Staunton Street, where they plotted the first Guangzhou uprising. This place was later rebuilt into Wing Sin Ung.
呢、这個興中會總會呢個地方，可以講係近代中國革命運動嘅起步點。以後孫中山先生所策動嘅革命咧，都係以香港為基地，所以我哋可以話咧，香港係近代中國革命嘅一個起源地。做嘢嗰度咧，多揾多啲。第一次起義就喺呢度做策劃。當時佢哋喺度開咗會議之後咧，決定由楊培雲就留喺香港，就買軍火進入去廣州起義噶。孫中山先生自己咧就親自去廣州咧，就成立革命嘅基地，然後咧就同佢幾個好朋友，包括陳少白、盧浩東，就喺呢度咧就係潛伏咧係發展嘅革命。同時咧同一時間咧，盧浩東都喺呢個地方咧係繪製咗革命嘅旗幟。咁佢哋終於喺1895年咧就準備起義，但結果呢個起義咧係並冇成功㗎。
Despite the failure of the first revolution, they received financial support from local merchants. Li Jitang and Deng Yinan were important supporters.
辛亥革命成功之前嘅好多次嘅起义里边咧，香港都系一个所谓呢个筹划起义嘅一个地方。最主要原因就系香港当时系英国嘅殖民地啦，咁变咗咧就清朝官府咧。就係管唔到呢一度嘅，咁變咗佢哋喺呢度嘅活動咧，就相對自由。另外一方面嚟講咧，香港佢嗰個位置咧，就啱喺正即係廣州嘅南面。咁呢個地方係一個轉口港啦，無論嗰啲革命嘅人員啊，或者係軍火咧，都好容易咧係利用香港作為一個轉運嘅一個中樞嘅地方。咁另外錢亦都係啦，因為香港個即係亦都係一個好自由嘅金融比較自由嘅地方啦。咁所以。其實香港係，而且你發現咧，就係歷次起義咧，其實距離香港都唔遠嘅。即係如果我哋畫一個半圓形咧，我哋發現其實香港一個核心嘅位置。咁所以變咗咧，就係一直以嚟咧，革命黨都利用香港作為一個係籌劃革命起義嘅一個基地。
Besides local merchants, Xin Chong Hui made the acquaintance of Japanese friends. One of them, Umiya Tsukichi, ran a photo studio on a street corner in Central. He went on to become an important supporter of their revolutionary activities.
每屋宗吉咧，佢嚟咗香港咧，就喺皇后大道咧，28号就開咗個照相館，咁啊叫每屋照相館。咁佢嘅經營咧非常之成功嘅，喺香港咧識咗唔少咧社會人士。佢對孫中山先生由於陰敬佢對呢一個嘅中國同埋亞洲嘅睇法，所以佢咧喺孫中山先生所舉行嘅革命運動當中咧，佢係提供革命經費，同埋佢亦都協助孫中山先生咧係購買軍火。
その日ですね、ずっとその夜中ずっともうあの日本語で簡単アイテラスというんですが、あの一晩中語り合ってですね、お互いの気持ちが一致したわけですね。からすごくそれまで親しかったわけではなく、その時に初めてあの孫文先生が自分の思いを梅屋に話したところ、梅屋もそれに賛同したわけですね。あの自分は自分たちの国、あのアジアはアジア人の手で、あの本当に平和な世の中を作っていかなくてはいけないというのを本当に若い時から身に染みて感じていたわけなんですね。その思いなんですね。あのその時にじゃあ誰がこの、あのまずは中国をきちんと何とかしなくてはいけないということだったんですけれども、じゃあその中国誰がその欧米列強を排除して中国人の手による中国を作れるのかといった時に孫文先生と出会ったわけですね。
With Umiya Tsukichi's financial support, Japan became Xin Chonghui's overseas connection. After the first revolution failed, Sun Yat-sen fled Hong Kong by sea to Japan. He first set foot in Yokohama. Tong Menghui was later set up here.
首先呢，他就是坐这个欧洲的这个客轮，直接由香港到这里来，都是外国轮船，都在这上来，就在这个港。但是那时候的港没有这样的大了哈，也没有修的这么漂亮了，那是比较很小的港，但只有在就在此地，嗯，地点没有变了。孙先生来到这个日本呢，主要的原因呢，第一个这个日本交通方便，啊，可以说横滨这个港啊四通八达，到欧洲啊到东南亚都非常方便。第二点呢，横滨华侨啊多半是广东人多。因为他有一种亲切感，有一种乡情的联系啊，语言也通。第三点呢，大家经济资源很多，尤其是日本朋友啊，也后来也同情他的革命，所以日本朋友经济资源上也很多。
Japan had the conditions for plotting revolutions. Revolutionaries who fled to Japan lived near Chinatown.Chen Xiaobai, Chen Xiliang, and Yang Kuwan met up with Sun Yat-sen in Yokohama. They lived there together for a period of time.
现在的位置啊，这是53番地，个兴农会成立的地点呢，在这里，国父就住在这里。第一次来到日本就住在这里。
而我就继续留喺华滨呢一度。
广州起义失败咗之后咧，就。孫中山咧就肯定咧就被驅逐出境嘅，咁楊其文為咗結合嗰個革命嘅力量咧，就去橫濱啊，同孫中山一齊，咁佢哋住喺孫中山嚟隔離添，咁孫中山先生都認識阿楊其文啲家人嘅。
When the time was ripe, Yang and the others left for Hong Kong. Sun stayed overseas. In 1900, the second uprising took place in Huizhou, Guangdong. It was directed by Yang Kuwan from Hong Kong.He lived here on Gage Street in Central. But this uprising too failed. Yang Kuwan did not leave. He stayed in Hong Kong with his wife and child, teaching English for a living. He was later assassinated by someone sent by the Qing court.There had been rumors of an assassination, but Yang Kuwan said, "Death is predestined by providence." We who choose to be revolutionaries have long thought nothing of life and death.
其實當時佢可以選擇，但係佢選擇唔逃亡。佢認為咧，佢對嗰啲人講，佢話我都唔會逃亡，唔避呢件事噶啦。佢話我話革命咧都隨時預備獻身於革命嘅。楊巨雲咧係我嘅堂伯父嚟嘅。咁但係睇呢件事咧，我就其實咧我係冇親屬嘅關係去睇嘅，我係站在一個即係香港嘅讀書人嘅角度去睇。我覺得呢件事唔應該當係一家族嘅事嚟嘅。我覺得應該係香港最珍貴嘅文化遺產嚟嘅，即係只有香港呢個地理環境、歷史因素，先至能夠造就咁嘅人物。
Traces of the 1911 revolution can now only be found on the historical trail and museum. It's not easy to find an historical building related to the revolution that's been preserved to this day. Dr. Lau Chi Pang, Assistant Professor of Department of History at Lingnan University, has brought Professor Lee Kam Kung to Ha Pak Nai Yuen Long in search of a forgotten village house.
即係文獻上係咁講啊，就係、是、鄧蔭南就1911年革命成功就就藥。
係。
咁呢度咧就吉咗，即係成班一齊走啊。係
係。
就應該係嗰陣時將間屋嘅交俾趙生嘅父親或者係祖父。
我老豆都話，即係唔係我哋嘅，即係同佢即係喺度保管啫嘛。
咁我哋從文獻上咧，首先了解到呢度係同當日革命有關嘅一個基地，然後當然再繼續係揾翻有關政府嗰個土地買賣嘅文件啦，咁啊證明咗當年咧，的確係鄧蔭南咧喺度買咗笪地咧，喺度起屋嘅。咁裏邊咧主要係用作咧係俾一啲革命人士喺度隱藏啦。咁裏邊有一個所謂工廠咧連埋一齊，就係做糖啦。同埋係中米嘅，咁另外咧亦都係表面上都係一個農莊，即作為掩飾都唔定。呢個土地嘅業權咧，我相信係鄧蔭南替阿李幾堂買落嘅，就未必係屬於鄧蔭南個人嘅資產嚟。
我嚟到第一個感覺就話，好顯然呢個就係一個革命基地，係毫無疑問嘅啦。咁李幾堂咧，佢就喺大概喺1901至02之間啊，就喺青山農場一帶買咗500-600亩嘅地方。咁佢最早呢個地方咧，佢其實係一種嘅經濟上嘅投資或者經營。咁啊，以後因為佢參與革命黨，所以呢度地方亦都成為咩咧？係提供俾革命黨咧，作為咧係掩護同埋咧係避難嘅地方。因為孫中山先生同埋佢所創辦嘅革命團體咧，喺香港嘅位置咧，實在現在咧所餘無幾。我哋嚟到呢個地方考察，發現呢個碉堡啊，好有可能性係成為咧呢一個嘅辛亥革命喺香港嘅唯一嘅位置。咁呢個歷史意義就非常之大啦。
Some historical traces have been forgotten, but turn out to be close by. Some have been removed by time.But there are descendants who strive to preserve them. Wong Sai Chung joined Tong Meng Hui late in the revolution. He was responsible for propaganda in newspapers. His descendants set up a museum for him near his old home in Guangzhou.
做一個紀念館咧，就遺留俾嗰啲後人咧，等佢係咪將來咧有一個紀念性啫。咁而係黃世仲有好多珍貴嘅。資料咧可能遺留過落去嘅，佢喺依個地方出生裏邊過去，使到佢嘅鄉人都知道黃世仲過去為國家做咗好多事。
作為廣東人，佢應該又係香港人，佢喺香港居住好一段時間。佢主要從事文字工作，往日嗰啲報刊都發表咗好多佢嘅文章。佢通過呢啲通俗嘅宣傳啦，就散播啲革命思想，特別對廣東啊、對香港啊、澳門啊，佢咧既係革命嘅，同時咧佢又係文學嘅，佢兩者融成一體，佢體現咗知識分子喺辛亥革命當中嘅重要歷史作用。 因為佢作為一個文人，當然係一個知識分子啦。佢嘅知識好淵博，就充分運用佢嘅知識啊，向人民嚟宣傳啊，使到孫中山嗰啲革命思想逐步逐步深入人心。
China Daily was located in Central. One of its sites was here on Stanley Street. Every day, an infinite number of people pass by. How deep an impression would it leave? This historical memory, so intimate to Hong Kong.